Now that we've learned about the technical aspects of EVs, it seems obvious that the most straightforward way of powering a car is by using PV panels that direct power to the electric motor. A prototype car with built-in solar panels was first built in 1982 by Hans Tholstrup, who later conceived a race called the World Solar Challenge, which is a biennial race stretching 300 kilometers from north to south Australia. The Nuon Solar team of TU Delft has been entering this race since 2001, and they have a pretty impressive track record. This dream team have won 7 times and have come in second the other 2 times they have competed. So what does it take to build a solar car, and how is it different from a normal EV? How can you make it best in the world? Today we visit them and talk with Jelmer van der Hoven, who is an electric engineering student working on the car called the Nuna 9S.
We build solar cars to race in solar races. We race in the Australia, where we do the World Solar Championship, and in South Africa, where we race in the Sasol Solar Challenge. And by doing this, we hope to promote sustainable energy. Well, Nuna, an electric vehicle, only uses the power from the power supplies, from the power outlet, and we use solely the power from the sun. Which is the main difference, but also how we use the output from the energy is also very different, because we want to maximize the power input from the sun and want to minimize the power that we use to race. Mm-hmm. And we minimize it by a couple of things. First, the drivetrain. A normal electric vehicle uses a shaft, which is powered by an electric motor, and we use an in-wheel electric motor. Mm-hmm. Which we only use one in the right rear wheel, and by using only one motor we also save weight, and you don't have the losses from the shaft. This is on the drivetrain, and we also have the air resistance and the rolling resistance. The rolling resistance is minimized by choosing as lightweight materials as possible. Our roll car is built from carbon fibers. Carbon fibers are very stiff and very strong. There's their weight to stiffness ratio is very high. This is why it's very good material for us to build our body. An electric vehicle is about 1500 kilo, 2000 kilos, and our newest Nuna 9 weighs only 140 kilograms. So that is very amazing that we can get such a low weight car.
Mm-hmm. And that really impacts the driving range, I imagine.
Yes, our driving range without the solar panels is around 500 kilometers, and we have a 5 kilowatt hours battery. And if you compare that to a Tesla, which can also reach around 500 kilometers, then the battery weighs around 500 kilograms, and our battery weighs around 20 kilograms. So that's a huge difference. The first generation Nuna was was a lot bigger. The solar panel was from the same kind of solar cells, gallium arsenide, but they were recycled solar cells from a Hubble telescope. And they had around 8 square meters of solar cells, and our newest, the Nuna 9S, they has around 2.6 square meters of solar cells. And also regulations have changed. The solar area was one of those regulations, but also the first Nuna had was a three-wheeler, and the regulations are now so that it has to be a four-wheeler. And the challenge in that is that the three-wheeler had a good that they had a good balance. And with the driver now sitting at the right side of the car and not in the middle, the balance is a little bit less harder to a lot harder to improve. That's still a little bit a secret what we are working on right now, but we are have a new software engineer which is working on a new board computer, and which will make it more intelligent, our vehicle. Yes, we have we can separate it in like three parts: the income part, the storage part, and the expense part. How we start with the income part. We have the solar array, which generates electricity, and to make it sure that the solar cells are working at their optimum point, we have maximum power point trackers. And what those maximum power point trackers do is to make sure that the maximum energy is generated from our solar array. And this is the IV curve of a solar cell. And what the MPPT makes, what the MPPTs do is to make sure that the power max is always reached. And he does it by sweeping around the voltage line to make sure, where he checks from at what point of at what voltage is the most energy flowing out of the solar array. And from the maximum power point tracker, the energy is flowing through the battery where we store our energy. The battery, as I told, was 5 kilowatt hours. They're made of lithium ion cells, and we make everything ourselves from the battery pack to make sure that the battery is monitored and keeping at a good temperature. We have a battery management system to protect our battery, that we know at what voltages all the cells are, and that we know if something errors appear, that we can act on that. And also inside the storage, we have the high voltage that is coming out of the battery, but also lower voltage that is made through a DC-DC converter. And from the high voltage, there's the motor controller and the motor. The motor controller makes sure that that the right gas response is given to the motor. And he does it through a three-phase connection to the motor, and with the changing currents from the motor controller, the motor creates an electric force which drives which drives our car. And from the low power side, from the lower voltage, is given to the board computer, which is a central communication hub in our car. The steering wheel is connected to it. Everything is connected actually through the board computer, which collects all the data. Further, we have also lights, so we can make sure that if you want to brake, the rest of the vehicles at the road know what we are doing. And we have also communication, because we have also cars driving around us that we can communicate to with a strategist also in a car, which says at which optimum point, at which optimum speed we need to drive.
And if we use this in a race in Australia, what would be a typical income from the solar array in terms of power?
That is around 1 kilowatt.
1 kilowatt. And the maximum power output of the motor?
The maximum output power of the motor is 5 kilowatt. So if it you need to accelerate, then you also use the power from the battery.
And if it's stable at going maybe 90 kilometers an hour?
It depends a little bit on the weather conditions, because if you have side winds, our car is so designed that it has a little bit like a sailing effect. so that it drives the car. And at 90 kilometers per hour, it could be possible that we are energy neutral.
Okay, well, cool. Can you give us a prediction of in 2030 what the Nuna car will look like?
The Nuna car will probably look like I think it will more a normal passenger car that will due to the regulations and also because it's still a race car that will evolve over time, and that it will be more intelligent, that it can do strategy, because at what speed it the best to drive from the weather conditions, that it can determine that itself, and because now we have a special car driving behind Nuna, which calculates all the weather predictions, all the calculations from what is the best speed to drive and other things that's calculated in a car behind Nuna, and that will probably be done also inside of Nuna. I think people will eventually drive with solar cells on their roof. Eventually it will mainly increase the range for now, but I think in highly solar adoration places, they have enough solar power to drive their daily juices.